Mau gil, pangyarihan lagi.
Oh, grabe kainit ang mga bata, grabe gipang kuan. Igo ragud ni nang nagkot, nang adli.
Sa tanggo.
Tagun tao?
Gamay raman? Wala may kuan?
I think they went early.
Gamay ra tita. Hi! Nice to see you, Tita S.
Hi, Sis Lynn. Hello, everybody.
Ah, pwede na siguro ito masugod.
Oh, sige.
Sige.
Pray na. Okay. Let us pray the Our Father. The name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Our Father,
our Father, who art in heaven,
holy be your name.
Holy be your name.
Your kingdom, come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Then the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Yes. Ate. Okay. So, sige, sis, Sister Teresa, ikaw mo'y mabasa. Ikaw okay. Po'y sharer.
Sige ba?
Sige.
Reading from the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 5, verses 1-12a. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn."
Can you give me the cell phone holder?
Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. Out of these beatitudes, I choose only one for reflection. This implies action. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. There is an act of charity and an act of mercy. If we are merciful, generosity follows. The seven corporal works of mercy falls on this beatitude. Feed the hungry, shelter the homeless, clothe the naked, give drink to the thirsty, visit the sick, visit the imprisoned, and bury the dead. For my personal reflection, this is what I had experienced before. The person whom I extended help and brought her to the hospital because her life was in danger was the same person who helped me save my foreclosed housing loan at Pag-ibig. The following week, I was promoted in my job, and my son also passed the board examination on physical therapy. The promotion was unexpected, but the passing of the board exam was what I am praying for. God gave me an excess baggage full of grace and of mercy. Thank you.
Praise the Lord.
Mara to akong reflection.
Giyon sa niyo pagtabang sis, ihatod niyo sa ospital?
Oh yes. Akong gidala sa hospital, Dok.
Babayi?
Babayi.
Nga naman, naon sa Manday siya?
Kuan, 1 month. Katong sana nga dirit pa kaning... Naman ko squatter man yung police station, kanyang dalang sa police station. Squatter na siya.
Sa una?
Then 1 month na to siya nag... O sa una, 1 month na to siya nag typhoid fever.
Mm-hmm.
Then, kay Juan Manggid Kayo, kanang squatter agon. So, ako'y nagdala sa hospital. Yun, gibalibaran pa mi sa Isimlaw kay... Dito sa nurse na daladala ka aning imong pasyente nga hapit naman ni mamatay. Iadto na lang ni sa Mars Jean. So,
nidala
na ko siya sa Mars Jean. Oo. Then, nabuhi siya. Then, mga pila ka years sir, naswertihan siya dito siya sa Japan. Then nakabana siya og Japanese.
Wow. So,
nakatabang siya.
Salamat.
Sa pamilya. Oo.
Niya sa Ginoo.
Niya paguman. Giyon sa niya pagtabang sa imo sa pag-ibig.
Akoan kining ni ang na foreclose lang kay mga bata, estudyante na nag-board sa ana, dagang kaayong mga kuan, then mga doon ako sa sick mother, sick katong twin na wala mag ninyo, na mama, na anak o tanan. Pag-abot niya sa, Japan, nag-send siya sa ako o Mama Mary nga kuan, postcard. Gibutan niya yung telephone number dito. Dahil yun, pag-abot sa sheriff, ni-register sa akong nauna nga musalay kong tawag sa iya ha, to borrow. I have to pay yun, lahi mong borrow. Then, when I said nga, ingon siya nga, much, 30,000. Siya nga, ay, dilit na lang pabayaran daw, ihatag niya. Ingon, no. Okay, ako gina siyang bayaran. Monthly lang po, og tag 1,000 a month. So, akong gihatag sa parents, sa mother, until such time na fully paid yung po sa iyong parents. Okay, dili, baro gud ang akong giingon. Then, at itong higayon na po, a week, sunod-sunod po na kwerte kay na-promote ko, unexpected. Dahil yun, akong anak po, kapasar po do board exam. So, motong na-exist ang baggage ni Lord, padala sa ako.
Praise the Lord.
Full of grace and mercy.
Abi na akong nagtrabaho siya sa pag-ibig, kuanday. So, grabe na. Pobre gid kay ito siya, pobre gid kay himalat yun naman yun. Wa kay kwarta ikatong hospital.
Yes. Wala gid dok, wala
wajud.
Ingon lagi sa naka. Oh, si auntie hikapa ako ang skin ba. Pag hikap ra ko sa skin kay murag paper na.
As in.
Na dehydrated na gid siya kay dok. Oh. Gigil balibara na gid mi sa law. Oh, then. Dadas siya sa Mars. Dito sa Mars din mga basta gipapalit ko atog 10 bottles of dextrose kay mura na gyud og ganang itabanguno na ba.
Grabe.
Nabuhi pag miss
adjust ko. Bugoy gyud ning Isimlaw no, di mo dawat no. Doktora Lea, Isimlaw. Joke lang. Ano
ba ato na siya no, primary hospital ra na siya, di na siya wala na siya ICU.
Mo na
diya. Siya.
So, we know when to refer.
Ah, okay. Very good. Sige.
Di ka magpatuga-tuga.
Sige. Correct. Dugay na maputo kayo sila, Doc.
Ah, okay.
Primary hospital na siya. Dili na siya for critical patient.
Okay. Sige, doktora. Okay, doktora.
Laban yun, ha? Laban.
Oo. Okay. Kaya mo yung dili mo bumalipad. Of course. Kay it's not a tertiary hospital.
Okay. It's not an ordinary sickness.
Sige, doktora. Okay, doktora.
You always know when to refer. Mas okay pa nang inana ka compared sa mag-alik-alik.
Yeah pa.
Kay patient needs a proper care and treatment.
Okay na daw. Kasabot na kayo. Okay, so, kasabot na kayo. Sige, sige.
Tuluan mo may asapaing.
Sige, padayon ta ha. Sige, thank you Sis Teresa sa imong nindot nga refleksyon ng sharing.
Thank you Sis.
Inspire me. Okay, ang topic nato karon is hello everyone, ang wa pa nako na greet sis Terry, Brad Brian, sis Kate. Oh, mawa pa nako na greet. Ang uban na greet na nako. Did Jesus institute all the seven sacraments? So, or is it just the invention of the Catholic Church? Sa una, wa pa ko kasabot. Wa pa kay ko kabalo sa pag sa atong katekism. Makaululaw kay dako na akong edad, kabaluan eh. Abi na ako mabuhi ra ko gulay sacraments. Ano ba may sacraments, no? Basa lang itay tayo itong Bible, tapos magbinuutan, okay na. So, wa ko kabalo nga di kita makasurvive ula ng sacraments. So, kailangan ba talaga ang mga sakramento para sa kaligtasan? Okay? So, Protestant objection. Okay? Nganong natay objection kanunay mga question because maumampun ni ang mga thoughts nga mo come across sa atong mind usahay, di ba? Kay labi nag makadungog tag mga storya, murang kayong puto sa atong nauna tuod, no? Anong ka, no? Kinsa kayo, no? Abi na itong basig imuhimo lang ni simbahan. Kay the Catholic Church, ang ilang objection is the Catholic Church added a lot of things that are not in the Bible. So, kanyang mga sakramento, palisod-lisod lang ni. So, did Jesus institute all the seven sacraments? The short answer, yes. So, ato explain nga nung answer, yes. Nga si Jesus gyud ay mismo ang nag-institute sa seven gyud na sacraments. No? Okay, Catechism of the Catholic Church, paragraph 114, official teaching of our church. Ang sulti, adhering to the teaching of the Holy Scriptures, apostolic traditions, and the consensus of the Fathers, we profess that the sacraments of the new law, all instituted by Jesus Christ our Lord. So, dili din ni siya, ginama lang simbahan. Si Jesus God mismo, katong buhi pa siya, siya ang nag-institute sa seven sacraments. Okay. Unsa isulti sa Council of Trent? Which Council of Trent happened 1545. Okay. Unsa isulti? Canon paragraph number 1. Canon 1. Session 7. If anyone says that the sacraments of the new law were not all instituted by Jesus Christ, our Lord, or that there are more than seven or less than seven, to wit, baptism, confirmation, Eucharist, penance, extreme unction, holy order, and matrimony, or even that any of these seven is not truly and properly a sacrament, let him be anathema. Wala ba sa meaning sa anathema? Let him be anathema. So, muna siya ang language usually sa mga council, sa mga canon. Ang kung kinsa ang magsulti nga dili tinuod ni, let him be anathema. Kung basahin mo sa dictionary, ang meaning sa anathema, let him be accursed. Okay. Now, another objection na po ni. Objection na po ni sa mga Protestante, nga nung mo-curse man ang simbahan. Nga, di ba ang sulti ni Jesus of 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 4, God our Savior who desires all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. So conflict ni siya sa message ni God nga tanan ang tao dapat iluwason nga nung let him be a curse, nga nung nag-condemn ang simbahan nga nag-curse, bawal na. Actually, dili gikan na sa simbahan nga term, gikan po na sa Bible, no? Sa Bible, Galatians chapter 1 verse 8, gi-apply lang sa simbahan ang unsay sulti sa Bible. But though we or an angel from heaven preach a gospel that is different, no, from which that we preach to you, so kinsa bisag kinsa ang nudlog sayo, let him be anathema. So ang meaning sa anathema is i-excommunicate, dili na ingon nga dalon sa impyerno or curse him to hell or damn him to hell. Gikuha na ang pagtulunan kanang excommunication sa 1 Corinthians chapter 5. So katong mga nagapabadlong, katong manudlo og sayop, katong dili mo tuo sa authority sa mga apostoles, No? You are to deliver this man to Satan. That's the word of the Bible, huh? You are to deliver this man to Satan for the destruction of the flesh, that his spirit may be saved in the day of the Lord Jesus. So meaning, ana, deliver man this man to the Satan, dili na siya pwede makakuan, makaparticipate sa sacraments, sa Holy Communion, excommunication, para madisiplina siya, para murepent siya. Kaya kung ma-repent siya, ang iyang spirit ma-save. So, ang iyang flesh ma-destroy sa punishment diri pa lang sa earth. Because, musuffer man siya because wala man siya participation sa communion sa simbahan. Excommunicated man siya. So, just like a gangrene, pag hindi mo naging putol, tibok lawas, mamatay. So, you really have to remove kasi kung na ay tao bitaw nga member sa simbahan manudlo bitaw og heresy sayop, delikado kaayo ma-infect ang tibok simbahan og ma-poison sa iyang mali nga teaching. So to remove one who is unrepentant in sin or obstinately teaching error from one's church body, you really have to remove it. So mo na ang term nga let him be anathema. So sidetrack, nag-digress lang ta para masabtan ninyo na nga let him be anathema. Okay. It's a strong word of the church warning that kung kinsa ang dili mo tuo, you are excommunicated. Okay. Next question. Are the sacraments necessary for salvation? Kinanglanon ba ang sakramento sa kaluwasan? Yes, they are really necessary. Dili siya optional. Dili kaingon nga makaadto kag langit nga mo skip ka aning mga sacraments, no? Canon 4, Section 5. If anyone says that the sacraments of the new law are not necessary for salvation but superfluous, meaning redundant, pwedeng wala ra, and that without them or without the desire thereof, men obtain through faith alone, kung kasi manudlo, faith alone lang, maluwas na, through all the sacraments are not necessary for every individual, let him be anathema. So, ang gisulti diri, dili man tanan gyud nga sacraments are necessary gyud. Pero ang sacrament as a whole necessary. For example, nganong ingon man diri nga though all of the sacraments are not necessary for every individual, kay di man ta pwede tanan ta magpare, di ba? Dili man ta pwede nga magbinyo tanan kung naay kuan. So though all are not necessary for every individual. Okay, so kita nato ang official teaching sa simbahan, the body of Christ, is that sacraments are necessary for salvation. Catechism 1129, the church affirms that for believers the sacraments of the new covenant are necessary for salvation. Okay. So, can we find the word sacrament in the English Bible? The answer is no. So, hala, dili na ito makita ang word ng sacrament. So, why do we teach it? So, muna nga tawag nga, is it not, because it cannot be found in the Bible, is it not biblical then? The answer is, it is biblical. The idea is there. The idea of the sacraments is there, but the actual or exact word is not. So it doesn't have to be the actual title. Like for example, Trinity. You cannot find the Trinity in the Bible, but the teaching is there. The idea is there. No? You cannot find Eucharist in the Bible, but the idea is there. No? Okay. So kining ang sacrament ng word, sa Latin, sacramentum, no? Gika na siya sa word ng mystery. Okay, so mystery can be found a lot in the Bible, no? So, sa Daniel chapter 2 verse 28, makita nato diya nga si God nag-reveal, gina-reveal niya ang iyang mga mystery, meaning knowledge, sa mga tao nga iyang gipili. So, one time, si Daniel, as in Nebuchadnezzar, nagdamgo. Nagdamgo siya. And then gusto niya pahulaan ang iyang damgo sa iyang mga manghuhula. So wala mang iyo makahula, makabalo kung unsay iyang damgo. Ya, wa mo'y pulos, pamatyon mo. Ya, kinsa man diri ang tao sa tibuok gingharian nga makabalo kung unsay akong gidamgo. Ya, inuingon to mga tao, imposible man kay na imong gi-request. Are, ingna sa mi ko na inyo unsay imong damgo para ma-interpret nato unsay imong damgo. Di man pud niya isugid kung unsay iyang damgo. Gusto siya nga naging tao nga makabalo kung unsay iyang gidamgo. So mo to nga si David ni presenta si David gi-reveal ni God kay David kay Daniel, dili David, Daniel kung unsay gidamgo ni Nebuchadnezzar. Og didto na namangha si Nebuchadnezzar nga ang imong Ginoo tinuod gyud ay. So mo na back story. So God in heaven who reveals mysteries. Okay. So ang mystery sa Greek ang tawag niya mysterion. Okay? The Jewish Bible into Greek. It is used in reference to the revelation of divine advice to a chosen few. So ang makadawat sa mysterion mga pinili lang. Okay? Mga privileged people. So Jesus answered to them sa Matthew chapter 13 verse 11, "To you it has been granted to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven." So you see, the mysteries of God is given only to those who are chosen. Not all receives the mystery, the kingdom of heaven, but to them it has not been granted. That's why Jesus said, "Blessed are you, Peter, Simon, son of Jonah, because not flesh and blood revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven revealed this to you." Katungingon siya nga, "You are the Messiah, son of the living God." Because God reveals His mystery to the pious and true. And then, sacramentum, mauna siya ang Latin word sa mysterion. I-translate niyo sa Latin from Greek, ay mo siyang sacramentum. So ang sacramentum, ang etymology sa sacramentum, ang iyahang etymology, i-dissect niyo ang word, originally, oath of allegiance sa mga soldiers sa emperor. So kung member na ka, nag-pledge na ka sa imong allegiance sa emperor, you are already a privileged one. No? You revere the emperor as God. So when you revere the emperor as God, you enjoy benefits, some benefits. Okay. Now, duha ka buok ang translation sa Latin. Sacramentum og mysterium. Take note, lahi po ng mysterion ha. Ang mysterion, Greek. Ang sa Latin, letter M, mysterium. Okay. So, made use of certain rituals only to those who are sworn to secrecy. Katugya po mga pinili. Okay. So, to make the long story short, mas nidaog between the translation sa sacramentum of mysterium, mas nidaog ang mysterium. Talagsa na lang ginagamit, wala na ginagamit ang sacramentum. So that's why kung mabasa kag Bible karon sa Bible, sa Latin Bible, dili di mo makita ang word nga sacramentum. Ang imo makita karon mysterium. Pero ang anong gigamit na sa church liturgical use ang sacramentum? Because si Tertullian, a 3rd century Christian writer, a lawyer, son of a soldier, nakita niya mas bagay gamito ng sacramentum because anak man siya sa soldier, kabalo siya sa mga language sa mga soldier, soldier's oath, di ba, ang sacramentum. So diha po niya na-relate, iyang i-correlate sa simbahan. Nga ang bunyag, usa ka sacramento, a beginning of life. Just like sa sundalo nga mag-pledge of allegiance na siya oath. So kung mahimo na siyang sundalo, nag-pledge na siya allegiance sa emperor, he receives a new life as a soldier bago na yung kinabuhi. So, iyang relate sa simbahan, nga kung mag-pledge ka allegiance kay Jesus through baptism, you have a new life also. That is why, mo na ang gigamit niya sa atong simbahan. Instead of mysterium, sacramentum. So, sa Latin Bible, makita niyo mysterium, walay sacramentum, pero gigamit nato sa atong liturgy is the term sacrament or sacramentum. Okay. So, kung gamitin mo siya sa church or liturgical application, meaning sacra or sacro, sacer, meaning holy, no? Or to consecrate. Sacra is sacred. Okay. So, in a simplest term, in a Baltimore Catechism, mga pangbata ang Catechism, what is a sacrament? So, there are three things to remember. It is an external sign instituted by Christ to give grace. Okay. Sayo na, mag-memorize. External sign instituted by Christ that gives grace. Okay. Christ Himself is the mystery of salvation. So, take note of the word mystery. Muna isulti ni St. Augustine, for there is no other mystery of God except Christ. So, what is sacrament again? An external sign. So, Jesus is the external sign of the Father. For there is no other mystery, let us replace the mystery of external sign, there is no other external sign of God except Christ. But we speak God's wisdom in a mystery, the hidden wisdom which God predestined. No? So, daghan ta makita ang word ng mystery. So, the mystery of God, it doesn't mean nga di nato na may hibawaan. Di lang nato matugkad, pero it is nang masabtad siya. No? Pero dili na matugkad. Attaining to all the wealth that comes from full assurance of understanding, resulting in a true knowledge of God's mystery, that is Christ Himself. So, the knowledge of God's mystery is Jesus Christ. So, if you are baptized in Christ, if you are baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, you are already the privileged one. That is why ang bunyag mga igsoon, mo'y entrance. Unang ang simbahan, kanunay mangayo o baptismal certificate. Kaya dili ka pwede maka-avail sa kumpirma, kasal, no? Dili ka maka-avail ana, Eucharist, kung wala ka nabunyagan, kaya wala epekto tanan. Useless tanan kung wala ka nabunyagan. That is why, ang simbahan kanunay kapangayo sa baptismal certificate. No? So, Jesus is the image of the invisible God. So, He is the external sign. He is the symbol of the invisible God. Jesus is the ultimate sacrament. Huh? He is the ultimate sacrament. Jesus in His very nature in the incarnation is sacramental. Everything Jesus did was sacramental. Tanang gibuhat ni Jesus, naagyoy sign, naagyoy mga symbol, symbolism. No? Even ang iyahang pagpakatao, the Word became flesh, is already sacramental. He is the visible sign of the invisible Father. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we saw His glory, glory as the only begotten from the Father, full of grace and truth. The Word became flesh. So, ang Word, Spirit, di makita, became materialized. It became flesh. Now we see it. And then, this flesh is full of grace. So, does it ring a bell? Sacrament gives grace. External sign. So why did God have to become man and not remain a spirit? Bitaw. Kailan na mo? Nganong si God, nganong di man ang tanya luwason, nga magpabilin lang dahil siya dito sa langit, nganong kinanglang magiging niya magpakatao? Nganong kinanglang magiging siya mahimong flesh? Dito lang dahil siya sa langit, o magtudlo-tudlo, mag-remote control lang siya, o, kana buhata, kana, ba? Nganong magpatao magiging siya? Because of our nature as man. Sa manday ng tao di ay? Ang nature sa man, we are hylomorphic being. A body-soul composite. So, hylomorphic, we have both body and soul. So, we are living in two worlds. No? We are citizens of two worlds. Living now in the world of the visible things. And also, in the invisible one. We relate to both worlds, spiritual world and physical world. The angelic and the animal world. So, natas tunga-tunga. No? Ang mga animals, purely physical. Kita, we are in between the angelic world and the animal world. So, muratag privilege ka ita. So, hence, Jesus, because kabalo siya ang kita mga tao, we have physical body and He loves us. In the incarnation, Jesus reaches us where we are. No? Jesus reaches us where we are because He loves us. He didn't become an angel because angel is just pure spirit. He became man. So angel are pure spirit. They do not need the senses to relate. So, dili kinanglan sa mga angel ang five senses. Smell, touch, taste, eyes, ears. No, dili kinanglan nila para maka-learn sila to communicate or to learn or to relate anything. They don't need it. They're pure spirit. Wa ta kabalo unsa ang pamaagi, but in a spiritual realm, no? So that is why God became man to physically relate to us. Because we need our senses to learn, to experience, no? Our soul, our spirit is attached to our body. They are united. So that is why makita mo na, this is the Mark chapter 7 verse 33 where Jesus healed the deaf mute, no? After He took him aside away from the crowd, Jesus put His fingers into man's ears. Iyang gibutang ang iyang finger sa dudunggan sa tao. Then He spit and touched the man's tongue. Miluwa siya ang iyang laway, iyang gibutang sa iyang kamot, gibutang sa dila sa tao. Kung inyong ma-picture out, medyo gross. No? He looked up to heaven and with a deep sigh said to him, Ephphatha, which means be open. So, deaf mute yung tao. Ha? At this, the man's ears were open. His tongue was loosened and he began to speak plainly. Okay. Did Jesus say, be healed? Mora ba na yung isulte? No. What did Jesus do? Again, Jesus spit and then touch mismo the tongue of the person. Imagine. Is Jesus powerful? Yes, He can do everything. But why would He touch it? He's trying to convey a message. No? He wants to give a symbolism, assurance, that people could see, na makita sa mga tao, the symbolism. So, everything He does is sacramental. pwede ko niyang sulting nga, oh, ayaw na ka, okay na. Muluwa pa siya, kinalaman pa man niya muluwa. Because this is in preparation for the institution of the sacraments. Mark chapter 8. He took the blind man by the hand and led him, sana po niyong katao, nga buta. He led him outside the village. When he had spit on the man's eyes, oh, giluwaan na po niya ang mata. Ganiha, giluwaan niya ang kamot, gihikap sa dunggan, o sa dila. Pero karon, giluwaan na po niya ang mata. Literally, spat on the man's eyes and put his hands on him. Jesus asked, "Do you see anything?" Jesus spit on his eyes and laid him on his hands and healed him. No? He spit on his eyes. Imagine, ah. He looked up and said, "Do you see anything?" Tubag sa tao, I see people, they look like trees walking around. So, medyo blurred pa. So, giotro ni Jesus. Once more, Jesus put his hands on the man's eyes. Then his eyes were opened. His sight was restored. And he saw everything clearly. And then, usa na pod ka instance, lahi na pod nga kuan. Si Jesus nagkuha na po siya mud. Ibutang na po niya og iyang laway o naghimo siya spittle. Huh? After saying this, he spit on the ground, made some mud with the saliva and put it on the man's eyes. So, unsa naman po niya stunt ni Jesus? Why would he need the mud? Kaya makain niya buhaton, di ba? So, this is sacramental. He's showing that as that God uses material things to transmit His grace, to transmit His power. Because we need it. Because we are physical things. We are physical beings. We need senses to be reassured. "Go," he told him, "wash in the pool of Siloam." Anong kinanglan pa man siya mag-wash? Sa pool of Siloam, pwede bang diretso na? So the man went and washed. Pag-wash, dito pa siya nakakita after he washed. And came home seeing. Jesus heals man born blind. So he's setting up, gina-set up niya ang institution ng sacraments. No? Leading to the institution of the sacraments. So why did he have to do this? Why not command directly without using visible things? Why would Jesus confess His grace to us using visible things? Why not directly, "Oh, you're forgiven"? Anong magamit pa man siyang pare? Anong magamit pa man siyang tubig, pan, bino, oil? Anong magamit pa man to confess His visible, His grace? Because Jesus know that we need it. We really need it. All our knowledge comes to us through our physical senses. Diba? Kung buong buhay mo, wa kay sense of smell. Kabalo ka kung i-describe sa imo ha ang smell sa rose. Imagine lang ka, pero di ka kabalo, di kita maputang sa imong brain. It will not be registered in your brain because wala kay experience of smelling the smell of a rose because you don't have the senses to pick up that scent. So dili na mabutang sa imong brain. Bisa kung saan ako na explain into words, never gid na nimo ma-conceive because you don't have the senses to for it. And then you know the voice of your mom, you know. We need to hear. We need to be touched. Studies have shown babies or children growing up na wala gina-hug, wala gina-touch sa parents are more likely to become psychopaths who shoots people in the school. They become psychopaths, mga heartless serial killers. Ito mga walay affection. Because we need touch. ikaw, kita kasi yung baby nga cute. Imo magyupon ito, nagimog yung hikabikapon, embrace, kisan. Because we really need physical affection. Di ba ka masugot ngayon mong baby, di na makita niyo sa bintana, napay bildo, di gini mo mahikap. Di ba? Kita, kinalan kita to express our love in touching. And then we really need to taste. We really need to see the beauty of nature. Naku, yung mga pasyente, may yung slag, kung di naman lang kumakita, may pagmamatay. Kaya pagkasubok, kaya kumakita. No? So we need to see. So all our sense, all our knowledge comes to us through our senses. Actually, come to think of it, kung wala bitaw ng imong five senses, sight, hearing, tanan ka ng five, wala na, ang imong brain will be empty. Di ka kadungog, di ka kita, di ka ka-taste, di ka katimaho, di ka ka-touch. Ang brain ni mo would be empty, according to research. Okay, we need tangible things as assurance. We need to see, to feel. Di ba ka matuo siguro, mahingon ni mong bana ni mo, I love you. Oh, I love you lagi, pero wala po siya pagsulti niya, I love you, wala po siya ga-smile, wala po siya ka nang nag-twinkle-twinkle lang iyang mata pag ingon niya, I love you. Ingon lang siya, I love you, with a flat face. Di mo hatag o gross, di mo hatag o gift, di mo cuddle, di mo embrace. Basta, I love you. Tuo ka? You really need, bisa pag unsa na ka, walay pulos na imong gihatag, people need assurance, no? Malipay sag naay gamay hatag. Saint John Chrysostom ingon, kung dili kuno kita were we incorporeal, meaning kung spirit kita, wala kita body, incorporeal, he would give us these things in a naked and incorporeal form. But now, because our souls are implanted in bodies, He delivers spiritual things under visible things. So, muna siya ang sacraments. Not that the qualities which are set before us in the sacraments are inherent in the nature of the things, but God gives them this signification. So, even if it's just appearances when it comes to the Eucharist, the bread and wine, no, sa Eucharist, the water for baptism, the oil in the anointing, the laying of the hands in the holy orders, the sacraments consist of spiritual component and material component. So, diri na siya makita sa the Word made flesh. So, the Word is the spiritual component and the flesh is the material component of the sacrament. John chapter 3 verse 5, unless you are born of water and spirit, you cannot see the kingdom of God. Unless you are born of water and spirit, ningon siya kay Nicodemus, dili ka makasulod sa kingharian sa Dios kung walay water and spirit. That is bunyag. Now, kabantay mo, water is material, spirit, siyempre, spiritual. No? So, diha pala, makita na itong there is material and spiritual component. Protestant objection. Well, it's not talking about baptism. John chapter 3 does not talk about baptism. It is about talking about accepting Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. Mo na isulti sa mga Protestant, dili na kuno bunyag. But the answer is there is no doubt that Jesus was really talking about baptism. Because if you look at the context, look at the passage around revolving this chapter. In the previous chapter, John was talking about Jesus being baptized. Baptism. And then, in John chapter 2, in the wedding of Cana, ang baptismal waters, water for purification, iyang gigamit para mahimong wine. So kanang water for purification mo na siyang baptismal waters of the Jews, no? And then Mark chapter 7, when they come from the marketplace, they do not eat unless they wash. So you water for purification na sa mga Jews, di kina sila mukaon or anything, basta dili sila maka-wash. So then right after that, what does he do? If you read down a little bit further, you will get to the famous born again discourse. Mo na tong, truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless he is born by water and spirit. So right after the born again discourse, you get John chapter 3 verse 22. Jesus baptized. Nang namunyag si Jesus, siya na po yung baptized. And then you go to chapter 4 verses 1 and 2. Gipadala niya mga apostles to baptize. So makaingon ka nga, it was really about baptism. Katong iyang gisulti kay Nicodemus, that you cannot enter the kingdom of God unless you are born by water and the Spirit. So the whole context is about baptism. So baptism is an awesome sacrament, example of a sacrament, because the form was given to us by Jesus himself. Gitudloan man kita unsaon pag baptize. Ingon si Jesus sa Matthew 28, ingon siya, go into all the world, teach all nations, baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. So gitudloan kita niya unsay formula pag baptize. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. That is the form. So take note. Teach them to do and say all in accordance to what I command you. And lo, I will be with you in the end of age. So, nganong kaniman nga picture akong ipili? Because we are instructed to teach what He commands. So, pasa-pasa. So, dili, basa. Kundi, by word of mouth, by teaching. Ulahin na lang ng Bible. No? Teach them to do. So those who hear you, hear me. Those who listen to the church is listens to Christ. Reading the Bible is good only when you read it within the guidance of the church who established, whom Jesus established. Mapuslanon lamang ang pagbasa sa Bible kung under the guidance of the church. But if you read the Bible to be inspired, and then naay mga lisod ng mga passages, and you interpret it against the interpretation of the church who compile the Bible, and the church that Jesus established, you go against the interpretation of the church, then dili maayo. So ang resulta, tukod ka sa imong simbahan. No? Mananaan na kayo nakaroon 45,000 Christian sects and denomination. So there you have the form, spiritual component, the words, and you have the matter of being water. You have the matter being water, and that's what a sacrament is. Not only did he teach it in John, but then he commanded the apostles to do it. Matthew 28. He that believes and is baptized shall be saved. He that he believes and baptized shall be saved. So diri nato makita ang isoon. Since baptism is a sacrament, di kita maluwas kung wala ang bunyag. You cannot enter the kingdom of heaven unless you are born with water and the Spirit. Okay, now let's go to confirmation. Mga rundown lang ni, dili kini siya ingon nga in-depth nga investigation sa kada sacrament, because ato lang i-prove nga si Jesus bagyod ang nang institute. Okay. So, Acts chapter 1 to 8, ni ingon si Jesus, ayaw sa mong lakaw sa Jerusalem, hulatanin niyo nga maabot ang Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit will come to you and will give you power. No? For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. And this is the confirmation. So muna may tabo, no? So nga nung wala pa man sila ipalakaw, di ba? Gisugo man sila nga mo-preach to all the earth. Pero wala sila ipalakaw because hulaton sa nila nga ma-empower sila sa Holy Spirit, because they hadn't received the power from on high. Confession. So klaro kaya ang pagtukod ni Jesus sa confession, no? John chapter 20, ningon siya, He breathed on them. No? So just visualize nga gibugha, gihuyupan gid sila. Huyupan sila ang mga apostles. And then gingnan niya, paghuyop, ningon siya, receive the Holy Spirit. Whosoever sins you forgive, they are forgiven. Whosoever sins you retain, they are retained. So, klaro kaayo, no? Whoever sins you forgive are forgiven. So ningon na mga Protestante, dili mana para mana sa tanang tao. No, dili ni para sa tanang tao ang instruction, para lang ni sa mga pinili, sa mga apostoles. Kay kung para ni sa tanang tao, una-una agad, una-una ha, kung para ni sa tanang tao, kung dili ni mo pasayloon ang isa ka tao, dili siya mapasaylo sa langit. Di may impyerno siya. So meaning, ang pagka-impyerno di ay sa isa ka tao na asa imong kamot? No. Dili na siya nga message gihatag para sa mga tao. Kaya nabi yung mga tao nga madumtanon, nga digid mga kapasaylo. So meaning, katong mga tao nga dili nila pasaylo, ma-impyerno to. Ma-appeal sa ka-impyerno sa ilaha. Kaya wala sila na pasaylo. Dili. This is applicable to the priest, to the sacrament of confession. Kaya ang sa sacrament sa confession, pwede nga dili mo hatag og absolution ng pare. Kaya may siya, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, I absolve you of all your sins. Pwede man na dili hatag sa pare na may rules during confession. Ang rules ana, isa ka example, kung makita sa pare nga ang tao dili repentant, dili siya matinunood anon nga naghinulsol, pwede siya moingon, I will not give you absolution. Si Padre Pio, daghan kay siyang tao nga wala ginatagalag absolution basta makita niya nga dili truly repentant ang sinner. Okay. So then he empowers to do the same thing and he did, namely forgiving sins like the paralytic man. I forgive you of your sins. Which is what our priests do today. The priests do not say, Jesus forgives you of your sins. Diba? Kung ang pare, magkumbisal mo, unsa may sultis pare sa imo ha? Jesus forgive you of your sins. No, wala. Unsa may ginasultis pare? I absolve you of your sins. As if sila mismo si Jesus. Because truly, they are persona Christi. They are the altar Christos. They are the representative of Jesus Christ. Nga naman, anong gingani man ni Jesus? Because He loves us so much. He knows that we need assurance that His sins were forgiven. Jesus wants us to hear His voice. Nga iya mismong tingog madunggan diha sa pare. So when the priest says, I forgive you, I absolve you of your sins, that is really Jesus talking to you in first person. That is why God is so intelligent, He's so bright. Nga iyan ang gihimo para dili bitaw third person nga Jesus is forgiving you. First person yun, because it affects our psychology. It affects our psyche nga that we heard that I absolve you of your sins. He knows what we need. Huh? He knew that The paralytic needed, he needed to hear the words, "Your sins are forgiven." And Jesus loves us so much that he gives us the priesthood so that we too can hear the same words. Just like what the paralytic heard from the mouth of the priest mismo, from the mouth of Jesus mismo. Jesus loves you so much that he wants you to hear, "I absolve you of your sins in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit," which gives us the greatest level of assurance, the greatest level of certainty that's possible to have. By hearing those words of our Lord and Savior, and really that's what the sacraments are all about. Tinod, that's what the sacraments are all about. That we really feel Jesus relating to us. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Okay. Unsa man ang gibuhat ning tawhana? Nagsaka sa building, magpa-picture, bahalag mahulog, basta sikat. Tarang tao, daghang kay mga tao magbuhat o mga kinabuang para lang mo sikat. O, kaniyo, pa-picture siya nga na ako na siya boyfriend, pero di ay, kamot rin sa manikin, gibutangan o picture. Kaya nga naman, ipost dahin because we want affirmation. We want those likes. Huh? Why? Because people need affirmation. We are hungry for affirmation. We need to feel our love tank. People longs for physical assurance. Na isa ka bata, ni hilak ni dagan sa iyang mama. Ngano nga hilak man ka? Tungod kay naipit akong kamot niya, ni adto ko kay daddy. Ni ingon ko kay daddy nga naipit akong kamot. Niya ano nga hurt man ka, ngano hilak man ka? Wala man gid ingon si daddy nga, "Oh, wa gid siya ingon ana." Na hurt kayo siya. Because ang tao wants sympathy. Wants God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that he became man, that the word was made flesh to minister to us where we are. Diba? Ang babae nga who's bleeding for 12 years, yeah, bisag mahikap lang ako ang sid-sid sa iyahang sanina, maayo ko. Dili siya kontento nga at a distance, bisag mahikap lang niya, na lang siya mahikapan, material. So, true enough, paghikap niya, power flowed from the cloth, from the tunic of Jesus. Yes, they are symbols or signs that communicate grace, that they symbolize to empower us to make heaven our home. No? So, Protestant objection, sacraments like baptism do not have the power to save us. Baptism is just like a public profession of your faith in Jesus to save you. So, actually, sacraments have the power to save us. Ningon sa 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 21. Baptism, ingon ang born again, mga Protestante, wala ko na gahom ang baptism to save us. Kuan lang daw na, formality lang na. No, unsa may sulti sa Bible. Baptism, which is like that water, now saves you. See? Klaro kayo. It has the power to save you. Bible na sulte. Okay? It saves you through Jesus Christ who came back from life to death. Now, why do you delay? Get up and be baptized. Wash away your sins. So, muna mga, paano? Di na nato na isa-isahon kayo. Wala tayo time, no? So, Paul already believed, di ba si St. Paul na buta? Gibuta ni Jesus tungkol kay kinapersecute yung mga Christians. So, katong nakakita na siya, giwalihan siya ni Ananias, nituo siya. Nituo na siya kay Jesus. Pero nga nung giingnan pa man siya ni Ananias nga, "Why do you delay? Get up, be baptized, so that your sins will be washed away." Because baptism mismo is not just a showbiz or a formality. It really can cleanse away your sins. It is our entrance into Jesus Christ, a relationship with Jesus Christ. We're talking about relationship. In order to enter into a relationship with Jesus Christ, you need baptism. Okay? Eucharist, so ana, transforms us into the image of Christ. Sacrament of matrimony, the two will become one flesh. What God has joined together, let no one separate. Matthew chapter 19. Mao kana si Jesus gapon ang Institute, anointing of the sick. So James chapter 5, niingon, is any man sick among you? Bring in the priest, anoint him with oil in the name of the Lord. No? So can we be saved by our own goodness without the sacraments? No. For it is by grace that you have been saved through faith, not from yourselves. It is a gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast. Ang ipasabot ani, the grace of the sacraments. Dili tungod sa imong kaayo, si Jesus nang pakamatay sa cross. Wala ni nagpasabot, kining gisulti bitaw nga, not by works, so that no one can boast. Dili ni ipasabot, dili importante ang good works ha. Ang ipasabot lang ani, dili tungod sa imong kamaayo, si Kristo nang pakamatay sa cross. Mao na nay pasabot ana diha. Wala na nagpasabot nga dili importante ang good works, which is the interpretation of the Protestants. Okay. Amen. Okay, I hope you understood something. So, hello, kisa may wala na ko na greet si Sarah, Brother Glenn, Sis Jo. Okay, isa pa.
Ang gabi, Dok.
Hello, Sis Jo. Ang gabi. Natoy one time nga nakita ta ka sa simbahan nakapula. Birthday man ito ni mo, no? Bantog ra nakapula ka.
Salamat. Ulahin
na kita pagkita sa Facebook. Birthday man eh. Sige. Sige, closing prayer ta.
Okay.
Ay, kadiyat ka. Kinsa may mo lead sa sharing next week. Kinsa mo volunteer. Kani. Kani bago si Sis Jo. Sis Jo. Sis Jo, ikaw mo volunteer. Read sa gospel o share next week.
Ako do?
Oo. Ikaw?
Sige do.
Sige. Very good. Salamat. Sige, closing prayer ta.
Sige. Let us all pray the Hail Mary. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy
Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. O Mother, health of the sick, pray for us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Mayang gabi.
Mayang gabi. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.